This year's Star June celebrations mark exactly 130 years since a group of 45 Anglican and Catholic martyrs were killed on the orders of Kabaka Mwanga. Since they were solemnly proclaimed as saints in 1964 by Pope Paul VI, pilgrims every year flock to the sacred grounds to honor the martyrs. The number grew bigger this year after Pope Francis' historic visit last November. As early as 6 a.m., the pilgrims had taken their seats at the Catholic shrine. Kiyinda Mityana Diocese Choir struck a chord with pilgrims with a spectacular performance. The Truth Will Set You Free formed the basis of today's sermon delivered by Mityana Diocese Bishop Anthony Zziwa.
We know that lack and the absence of the truth leads to many social evils today in our community. For example, corruption, domestic violence, murder, embezzlement of public funds.
The Kiyinda Mityana Diocese is one of the areas where the seeds of the Catholic faith planted by Noah Mawagali, Ambrose Chibuka, Luke Banabachintu, and Matia Mulumba have sprouted.
It is wrong for a Christian to live a double life. For example, being a Christian during daylight and behave like a pagan at night.
The pilgrims came from as far as Iran, Singapore, Kenya, Tanzania, among others. The celebrations were attended by politicians, cultural leaders, and foreign dignitaries. President Yoweri Museveni, who is currently away in Germany, was represented by Vice President Edward Sekandi, who spoke of government's commitment to improve religious tourism.
Government has already contributed 32 billion shillings towards development of this place and to give additional 16.6 billion shillings this financial year.
All the speakers spoke of the need to emulate the martyrs if they are to strengthen their faith in Christ.
They spoke the truth, even if it was going to cost them their lives.
So let us promote truth in our lives, in our homes, in our communities, at work, in our respective churches, so that, like Mulumba, especially for us Catholics, that we should live and die as Catholics.
Maria Nyerere, wife of Tanzania's founding leader Julius Nyerere, who is a regular here, did not attend this year's anniversary because she's sick.
The key message from this celebration has been that Ugandans must embrace the truth if we are to be set free as a country. My name is Sudan Rutre at Namugongo Catholic Martyrs Shrine. I'll now hand you to my colleague Maurice Achol, who was at the Anglican Shrine, to give us the highlights of what transpired there.